स्टार्ट। ओम शुक्लां वरदरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ओके सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट लर्निंग लेट अस रिवाइज द lines that we learned till now, that is I think 1.1.33, that is till Brahma we had learnt a few names. I'll just share my screen.
Yeah.
we had learnt only till 1.1.33, right? So we just completed for Brahma. Anyone remember?
Yes.
Kamalasanaha, correct?
Okay.
Okay. Now before we continue learning, let us look at. Sorry.
Thirty-four.
Okay.
Thirty-four.
Okay. So Srashta, Vishwasrit Vidhi, that is the last one. Okay. So now for, I think till gods, devatas, triyam, we had seen the meanings. For a few more, we will see the meanings and then we will continue. Okay. Now, next is, after we finish the gods, so we have seen different names for heaven. Then for gods, it is done. Basically, the category of gods, what they are called, Amara, Nirjara and so on, we saw it in there. Next is now clans. Now, clan basically means group. So, they are in, you can say, you can consider them to be in the middle category. One is gods, something in the middle. And then you have some more third category, demigods. Then we have gurus. All of us, we have some religious leader, some guru in our name. And finally, it is human being. So, even in gods also, there are different categories. As I said earlier also, this is not just to discriminate. But just as we have different designations, someone who is an elderly person or someone who is more knowledgeable, we place such a person at a higher post, right? So, similarly, in gods also, this is how the categorization is done. So, next is some clans or deities that are there. First, note down the breakup and the gender. Aditya from there. Aditya Vishwavasavas Tushitabha Swara Anilaha. Aditya Pullingam. Aditya Pullingam. Aditya, you can note down the main word. Vishwa Napusakalingam. Vishwa Napusakalingam. Vasuhu is Pullingam. Here it is given as Vasavaha. That is because in the words, in the shloka, it is Bahuvachanam, so it is Vasavaha. Originally, the word is Vasu. It's an Ukarantam word. Vasu. Pullingam. Aditya Pullingam. Vishwa Napusakalingam. Vishwa Napusakalingam. Vasavaha Pullingam Bahuvachanam. Vasavaha Pullingam Bahuvachanam. So, the main word will be Vasu. Tushita Pullingam Bahuvachanam. In the word it is Tushita. Tushitaha actually. How we have Ramaha Ramau Ramaha. Similarly, Tushitaha Tushitau Tushitaha. Bahuvachanam. That is plural. Original word is Tushita Pullingam. Abhaswara Pullingam. Abhaswara Pullingam.
The line number I didn't get. Is it 1.15?
Anila Pullingam. Sorry, which line?
19. Okay, 1 year.
Anila Pullingam. Now with regards to this Vishwa, sometimes some people also consider to be like how we say Vishwam world. Some say Vishwaha. Pullingam. So therefore here there is a confusion. Though it is given as Apusakalingam, at times it can be Pullingam also. Now such changes are because depending on the place, like as we had also discussed earlier, though we have a dictionary meaning, sometimes depending on the area or all of us, we speak in different accents, right? So it is not wrong, but because of our mother tongue or maybe because of the place where we live, we have some influence of that. Similarly, this Vishwa, though it is Napusakalingam here as per the meaning, but sometimes it can also be Pullingam. So therefore, just make a note. So that is the reason here separately. Like for example, it's in clean and all that, right? Clean, pumsi, such words are used to indicate Napusakalingam. Here, such an indication is not made because it can be used even in Pullingam at times. For now, note down as Napusakalingam. Vishwa Napusakalingam. Second line, Maharajika. Maharajika Pullingam. Maharajika Pullingam. Sadhya Pullingam. Sadhya Pullingam. Rudra Pullingam. All three words. Maharajika, Sadhya, Rudra. All three are Pullingam. Ganadevataha. Ganadevataha is just true that these are the clans of deities, groups of deities. You can say like a group. So Ganadevataha. Next also note down for Devayonihi. What are Devayonihi? These are, you can say, demigods. They are called Devayonihi. Yonihi meaning womb. Womb. So mostly those who are born out of the womb of gods. Now here it literally doesn't mean a biological birth. Okay. What it means is that they have some divine qualities in them, but they are not still reached to the level of gods. So somewhere like that. So like how we have in the case of gods, you have Manasaputraha and all such, right? So somewhere similar to that, that is how we call them demigods or Devayonihi. Okay, next two lines for Devayonihi, note down. Vidyadhara. Now this is all very common. Most of you would be knowing about this. Vidyadhara Pullingam. Vidyadhara Pullingam. Apsaras. Apsaras Strilingam. By default, all of us know Apsaras are the dancing girls who are found in heaven. So Apsaras has to be Strilingam. It is Sakaranta Strilingam. For example, if you see, when we had discussed about Chandramaha, I told you Chandramaha. Chandramaha, Chandramasau, Chandramasaha, Prathama. Chandramas is Sakaranta Pullingam. It ends in Sa. Similarly, Apsaras. Many people get confused. They feel Apsara. Oh, Apsara. It is Akaranta. It ends in A. It is like Mala. Apsara, Mala. Usually, women's names end in A. So, therefore, it can be Akaranta. No. Apsara, the original word is Apsaras. Sakaranta word. It is. It ends in Sa. And it's how you call out. The main word is Apsaras. Then we say it is Apsara. Okay. Vidyadhara Pullingam, Apsaras Stree. Sorry?
Apsaras is Vidya
Halanta. Yes, Halanta sir. Apsaras. Next is Yaksha. Yaksha Pullingam, Raksha Pullingam. Please mute yourself, everyone. Lakshmi ji, mute yourself. Yaksha Pullingam, Raksha Pullingam, Gandharva Pullingam. Again, Gandharva Pullingam. Now again, I hope everyone is not rewriting the words again. Just put a pencil. Otherwise, it will take a lot of time. Just put a pencil. With a pencil, you can just put a line and write there. That's it. Gandharva Pullingam, Kinnara Pullingam. Now please don't get confused between Kinnara is actually a class of gods who are there. People, we call even the third gender in our common language, we Kinnar, we say in Hindi, right? That is actually Napusakalingam. But in Sanskrit, Kinnara is also a class of gods, and this is one of the reasons why in our scriptures, though today we human beings, I'm not saying all of us, but still we human beings look upon the third gender, we tease them or we consider them to be, you can say like at a very low level, we look at them with an inferior mentality and so on, but all our scriptures, including the Amarakosha, has given them a place, and Kinnaras are also one category of demigods. That is the reason even in the Mahabharata also we have one Kinnara. Who is that?
Shikhandi.
So, never ever, though he was, the birth story behind him is different. It was Amba Ambika, that story that is there. Then he took a rebirth as Shikhandi, that is there. But then still, Kinnaras on all our scriptures, books, and also in the Amarakosha, we have always given them a proper place. Though here now Kinnara is not much compared to the third gender, it is a category of demigods, but this signifies that our culture has always respected everyone, irrespective of their gender, qualities, age, caste, creed, class, where you are born, what you do, and so on. Today, if we have any discrimination, that all is man-made. So therefore, we have to think 10 times when someone comes and says that, you know, everything in India is like this, or Indian culture promotes this, Hinduism says this, Sanatana Dharma is always very orthodox, it shows a lot of discrimination. Now you have very clear answers, you can surely give people explanations. This is not just to answer others, but for our own understanding. Most of us, we are confused at all times. When people poke fingers at us, we feel we don't have answers to give them back, right? So therefore, and all this, it is not just to answer someone, but for our own knowledge, and at the same time to remove so many wrong notions that are there. It's very easy to pass things, especially such sensational news. But when you know the right answers, it is just because it's not that everything is known by everyone. When we don't know something, before we pass on comments, Okay, now I started studying, now I know about it. Not only Amarkosha, you have references in so many places. So, point that I'm trying to say is, it's very easy to get influenced by people. So, they might be wrong or they might be right, we never know. But from our side, until and unless we do a proper research, only then we can comment on things. How to do research? Only when we open our books and study, at that time we get right answers. Okay, next we continue. So, the line I'll repeat again.
Pulling, yes.
Vidyadhara pullingam, apsaras strilingam, yaksha pullingam, raksha pullingam, gandharva pullingam, kinnara pullingam. Next line, pishachaha. Pishacha pullingam. Pishacha, usually ghosts and how we consider. Pishacha pullingam, guhyaka pullingam, guhyaka. Siddha pullingam, bhuta.
Guhyaka means?
I'll tell you the meaning. I'm just telling you the lingam.
Okay.
Yeah. Guhyaka pullingam, siddha pullingam, bhuta pullingam. Last again, devayonayaha. These are a class of demigods. Pishachaha, pishacha, guhyaka, siddha, bhuta. Everything is pullingam. Okay. So we have seen for ganadevata and devayoni. Now we look at the meanings. Aditya, first word itself, son of Aditi, Aditya. So basically, Aditya in this reference is referred to the sun god. We have another name for the sun god, Aditya. In general, the sons of Aditi are even for devas. That's why we have seen in the Amaranirjara, Deva, the Amarkosha for gods. There also we have a term Aditya. But here it is Aditya. It actually means the sun. 12 Adityas we have. Sun and all the other gods, even Vishnu is one of them. These are all demigods, or you can not demigods, you can say a group of the second category of gods. Aditya, sons of Aditi. Next, Vishwa. Now, Vishwa is also used as another name for, can anyone guess which god? Vishnu. Vishnu Sasarnama, Vishwam Vishnur Vashatkaraha. Vishwam literally means the universe, the one. You can say who encompasses the entire universe, how we say. That's the meaning even in the Vishnu Sasarnama. So, Vishwa, the root is Vish. Sanskrit Dhatu is Vish. It means to, you can say, to occupy or to pervade. That is actually Vish. So, Vishwa has come from that. Vishwa meaning any god in general. The second category of gods is usually means, in the Rig Veda, you call, it is for a class of gods. Like we have the 12 Adityas. Similarly, Vishwas are also a category of gods, but it is also another name for Lord Vishnu. Next, Vasu, Ashtavasus we have. Ashtavasus are also a group of deities. Usually these gods are associated with fire. When we worship fire, Agni Bhagwan, we call the Ashtavasus. Now there are Ashtavasus who, like as times keep changing and as per different Puranic references, once again. Can everyone hear me now? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So, could you...
Lakshmi Akka.
Okay. Could everyone hear Vishwa? I told you about Vishwa. Was that audible?
No.
Totally
no. Okay. So, Vishwa is another name for Lord Vishnu. For example, in the Vishnu Sahasranama also, we use the first name Vishwam Vishnur. The Vishwa, it literally means universe. So, Vishnu is considered... like the entire universe, one who pervades the entire universe, that is Vishwa. Vishwa, this word has come from the Sanskrit Dhatu, verb Vish, meaning to pervade or to occupy, that is Vishwa.
Sarvavyapi.
Okay. Next. Vasu, we have the Ashtavasus. Now, Ashtavasus, depending on every Purana, depending on the time period, the list differs. Just as we have the Saptarishis, Saptarishis category also differs. So, similarly, Vasus also, depending as per different Puranas and the Mahabharata, you have the reference, you have the names of Ashtavasus that are different. Usually, this Ashtavasus are considered to be natural elements, like for example, sun, water, air, wind, and so on. So, Aditya, Prithvi, Varuna, Agni. These form a clan of Ashtavasus. Next, Tushita. What is Tushita? Tushita is the lord that rules over heaven. Now, heaven also, as per Garuda Purana, we have a reference that there are seven heavens and seven hills. So, two special heavens that are there, they are Yama and Nirmanarati. Those who are interested, you can just note down these names. Yama, this is one heaven, and Nirmanarati. Out of seven, these are names of two heavens. So the Lord, or you can say one group of gods, there are about six in all, they rule over this place, this heaven. So for all the heavens and hills, just as we have Mahabali from the Vamana Purana reference, who rules in Patala. Similarly, this Tushita is a clan of deities who rule over one of the heavens, or they are located between two heavens out of seven, between two heavens. So basically all these things are there, and that is the reason it is being mentioned in Amarakosha. A few things are popular, like for example about Mahabali, we know because Mahabali was given a place, the Vamanavatara story, in that Vamana tells Mahabali, you go and stay in Patala, you rule over there, therefore we know about this. Whereas for each of the heavens and hell, we have a ruler, or you can say like Rakshaka, like a master who rules over that place, who takes care of the place, like that. Ruler of one of the heavens is Tushita. That's why it is included in this clan of deities. Next.
I have one doubt, Amma. So what you are speaking is, Swarga Loka is not unique. There are seven.
Swargaha in general means heaven. Heaven is also divided into seven parts. So depending on one's own good deeds, you have to come back. Like for example, we have difference between Vaikuntha and Swarga. Swarga is limited. Indra lives in Swarga, right? So once your good merits are done, once the results you experience, everything again, you have to take rebirth. That's the reason why even Indra and Brahma also, they get changed. Indra is the name of a padavi, not a proper noun. Therefore, that is the reason all of us, we must not pray that I have to go to heaven, not Swarga Loka, because in Swarga Loka it is just mere enjoyment. You don't have dukkha there, but once your good merits, everything is done, then you have to come back and take a rebirth. So therefore, we all pray that we must go to Vaikuntham, Rudra Lokam, Sagachati, and so on. So when we pray there, again we don't have to take a rebirth. So this is what we believe. So there also, depending on one's good deeds, heaven is given. Which heaven we have to go, that is decided. Similarly, for Papa also, depending on the sins that we do, there are seven heavens, so we are placed accordingly. Okay. Next, in detail, if you want to read, you can read the Garuda Purana, that mainly talks about seven hells and seven heavens.
Seven heavens are representing seven grades of punyas.
Grades, correct. Great. So depending on one's karma that we do, you are placed in a particular heaven.
Okay.
So this is all about Swarga Loka. Next, you also have Brahma Loka and Mahat Loka and so on. But there is also one that is Vaikuntham and Kailas. There usually all of us, we must, or most of our scriptures, if you say, they all you can say they show a path to reach Vaikuntham or Moksha, as we say. Okay, coming back, next is Tushita. So like this, Tushita is a deity that rules over a class of deities. Now make a note of this, Aditya Vishvabasavaha Tushita. Now this is not just one god. You see, Gana Devataha, Gana itself means a group. So they are a group of deities. For example, Gita chapter 10, Aditya Anamaham Vishnu, amongst the Adityas. So like this, Rudranam Shankarashchasmi, amongst the Rudras I am Shankara. Like this, it is a group of deities. They are not just one. So they are a group together. So for this, Tushita also is a group of deities, about six it is said roughly. Now this number can differ. Like in Puranic stories, you see there can be a bit of differences in the numbers, time period and so on. So therefore, this year also, though it is mentioned as six, you can consider that to be a rough figure. In general, you can consider a group of deities, not a single one. Next is Abhaswara. What is Abhaswara? Abhaswara is also a group of deities, or basically devotees of Lord Shiva. Mainly they live in Kailasa. How we have the Bhutaganas, the most popular, or you can say we know about Nandikeshwara, Nandi. Apart from that, there are many more Bhutaganas. So this Abhaswara is a category of Ganas who live in Kailasa. They are all devotees of Lord Shiva. Next, we have Anila. Now, Anila is one word that is used even for Vayu. Vayu Bhagavan, Anila. Hanuman has got a word, Anila Putraha. So mainly Anila is one name for Vayu himself. And Anila is considered to be one of the eight Vasus. Because as I told you I told you about the meaning of Vasus usually consist of natural elements. So earth, wind, fire, water, and so on. So similarly, this anila can be used for Vayu himself, or second meaning anila, when we consider a group of deities, they can be, you can say, the servants of Vayu or the attendants of Vayu. So there are two meanings to this. Anilaha, Vayuhu, Anilaha. These are two words that are there. So anila can be Vayu himself, or second meaning attendants of Vayu. Okay. Next, Maharajika. Now Maharajika is another name for Lord Vishnu. This reference comes in the Mahabharata. This name is used in the Mahabharata for Lord Vishnu, Maharajika. Now, we all know Maharaja, right? Maharaja means a great ruler. So, Vishnu here is given that name, meaning one who is like a great guide. Now, in the Mahabharata, it was Krishna in the form of, Vishnu in the form of Krishna who had come. So, therefore, he was like a leader for the Pandavas, and ultimately, the entire Mahabharata story is around Krishna, right? So, or even the Srimad Bhagavatam also you can consider. So that is the reason why in the Mahabharata we have a name for as Maharajika for Lord Vishnu. So this is one category of gods.
Only one small doubt.
Yes.
When we are talking of Dhyan of deities, deal-level deities,
huh,
why Lord Vishnu comes in this?
Yeah. Now here basically Maharajika here, though it is used in general for Lord Vishnu, it was also used for, you can say, Maharaja, how this word has come, for great kings. That is the reason even kings like, for example, let us take a very famous example, Raghuvamsha. The entire Raghuvamsham, if you see, now Raghuvamsha, in that also you can call all those kings, like kings who are equal to gods, you can consider. So like for example, Raghu, Dilipa, Dasharatha, Raghu mainly, Raghu Vamsha, even though Rama himself, Lord Vishnu himself was born in this Vamsha, in this family, still it is not called as Rama Vamsha, it is called Raghu Vamsha. Why so? Even though the god is incarnated, still Raghu, because of his great qualities. So you, like this Maharajika is a term which is used for a group of, you can say, kings who are like equal to gods. Or now in the Mahabharata, there were a few kings. As per the Mahabharata reference, it has to be used for Lord Vishnu. But in general also, this term is used for those kings mainly, or those rulers who are like equal to gods, or who had divine qualities. That is the reference. Okay?
Okay.
Yes.
Marut,
Anila, that way. Next is Sadhya. Sadhya, sorry.
Is it the same Marut and Anila?
Marut, Anila. Now, Maruts are actually two some. Maruts are in all 49 in number. Anila also you can consider to be same, but here the word has not been specified as Maruts. It could come in some other place. Therefore, in this reference, you can consider them to be the attendants of Vayu, not of Marut. Okay. Though the meaning is somewhat similar, we cannot say same. It is similar. That's all.
Maharajika.
Maharaj.
Okay. It is Lord Vishnu, but Maharaja, king. Maharajika.
Rajika, meaning now how we say Dasharatha, Dasharathi, right? So meaning Maharajika is someone having divine qualities. Maharajika. In Sanskrit, if you want, I'll tell you the definition. Mahati Rajihi Panktihi. Meaning Mahati, meaning great, great qualities. Mahati Rajihi. Rajihi is divine. Or you can say royal qualities. One who is having good qualities of a king. Like for example, even Rama also, Maharajika. Like this, the entire Raghuvamsha, in that also kings are named as Maharajika. In the Mahabharata, you Ramayana, you have Rama, that's why we have Ramarajyam. Like that, Raghu, all the kings of Raghuvamsha were great rulers. So therefore, you can use the word Maharajika for them. But in the Mahabharata, if you see, the rulers, usually for Krishna, it is advised. Because in the Mahabharata, as per the story goes, we didn't have, like the Ramayana, we didn't have kings like that. So therefore, as per Mahabharata, Maharajika, this word is used for Vishnu. But in general, when we are talking about group here, like for example, Ganadevataha, when we say, it can be used for those kings who are like equal to gods, or who had divine qualities. Or people respected them like gods only. Maharaja is a king, or you can say a great king, but Maharajika, one having divine qualities. That is equal to God. That way. Okay? Yes. Next is Sadhya. Now Sadhya, these are also a category of, you can say, demi, second category, minor gods. And they are said to be the sons of Dharma. Dharma, Yama, god of death, Dharma. So Sadhyas are said to be those categories of gods who are sons of Dharma. And Sadhya, now how this word Sadhya has come? Their mother's name was Sadhya, Dharma and Sadhya. Sadhya was a daughter of Daksha. Among the Prajapatis, Daksha had 27 daughters in all, most famous Sati and Rohini. all these 27 daughters were married off to the moon god, but most famous is Rohini. He was very much the moon god considered Rohini to be his favorite wife, and but one of the daughter was Sadhya. Sadhya and Dharma, their children were Sadhyas, because their mother was Sadhya, that's how they got this name of Sadhya. There are about 9 classes of deities. Okay, next is Rudra. Rudra, we know, very famous, 11 Rudras we have. Rudra is a clan of Shiva. Next, Devayonihi, with this Ganadevata ends. Next is Devayonihi, divine beings. Vidyadhara, now I'm not going too much into detail. Vidyadhara, Apsara, we all usually know about this. Vidyadhara, Apsara, Yaksha, Raksha. Now Raksha, Yakshas and Rakshas usually are the protectors or attendants, gatekeepers you can consider of heaven. Gandharvas are known for entertainment. Chitraratha, Gandharva Anam Chitraratha, 10th chapter Gita. Gandharvas, music and dance. Kinnara, we have already seen, again a category of deities. Kinnara, basically, you can consider Kinnaras to be half man and like half bird or something like that. So sometimes some people say that they are even birds like Garuda and so on are sometimes referred to Kinnara, but not always, but in some reference, like for example in a few Puranas it is referred, so in the Upa Puranas, not the Ashtap, 18 Puranas, sometimes in Puranas it is given that Kinnaras can be even a category of birds, like for example Hanuman if you consider, or Jatayu, Sampati and so on. So they are all, you can say they are not full 100% birds. They were also, they had even human qualities, right? Like for example, Hanuman and so on. They could speak. Jatayu, Sampati. So they all form in these category of gods. They are not actually gods, but the second level. They had a few divine qualities in them. So Kinnaras, mainly they play musical instruments. So Kinnaras are mainly known for playing musical instruments. Next is Pishacha. Pishacha, spirits or ghosts. Guhyaka. Guhyaka, they are like, they are actually the attendants of Kubera. Kubera, god of wealth. So Guhyakas, they live in caves, and they said Kubera is said to have a lot of wealth and treasure, and it seems that he keeps them in caves safely, and these Guhyakas protect the caves by standing outside, and that's the reason Kubera, god of wealth, has got another name, Guhyakadhipati. Guhyakadhipati, this is another name for Kubera. So Guhyakas usually, now Guhyaka, why this name Guhya, mainly means hidden, something which has to be kept secret. Now when some wealth is kept, we have to be careful, right? Or people should not know that wealth has been kept here. So therefore these Guhyakas also, when they are protectors, when they stand outside the cave, it is said that they don't, like people cannot see them. Like now when, say for example, few of us also have this habit, right? Say for example, you go to the bank and you are maybe withdrawing a lot of cash. Some people have this habit of keeping them in a very old bag, or maybe among some vegetables or something, you keep it under that, so that we don't get a doubt that okay, this person has got a lot of cash. Similarly, this Guhyakas also, they ensure that they don't stand exactly outside the caves. They stand maybe the hidden behind it. Now usually caves or in mountain caves, they are usually in the jungle, right, in the forest. So they will hide themselves. That's the reason they have got this name as Guhyakas. And Kubera, because he is a leader, he is a ruler of these Guhyakas, another name for Kubera is Guhyakadhipatihi. Guhyakadhipatihi.
One doubt, Lakshmi.
Yes.
This
researchers,
how they have categorized and
this
one.
Sorry, what
you
are saying?
Nowhere they have got any divine qualities.
Now see, when a person dies, we consider that he becomes a ghost, right? Pishacha need not always be a negative element. Now all of us, when we die, we are all going to become ghosts and spirits. That doesn't mean all of us are evil, right? Some of us can have even good qualities. But ultimately, whether you are good or bad, though in the common language we associate Pishacha in a negative reference, but still Pishacha generally means ghost. So those who give up their body, that is once the soul leaves the body, the ghost form that is there, for example Preta we call when we do the rituals, right? After the 10th day rituals, the word Preta is not at all used. So Preta literally means, you can say, a body or a ghost, spirit that is moving around here and there. So that form is actually called a pishacha. Therefore, it cannot always be associated with a negative term. That is maybe with evil qualities and so on. Therefore, that now all there can be all of us. It's not that all of us go to hell, right? Some people can even go to heaven. Everyone leaves their body. Everyone casts their body away. That form is pishacha. So therefore, it can it actually falls in the class of you can say divine qualities because it can also go to swarga loka. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Next is sadhya, sorry, vidya, pishacha, guhyaka, siddha. Now what exactly are siddha? Siddhas, mainly they are, again, they live in Kailasa, they are the devotees of Lord Vishnu. And it is said that siddhas are also considered to be, siddhas are the ones who also assist goddess Durga, it seems. That is why those who are familiar with a bit of Shaktism, maybe you chant some stotras in praise of Devi, you have some certain mudras that we do, right? Certain mudras, or you have certain tantric practices, tantras that are followed. Siddha Vidya, we say. Siddha Vidya, this name comes in the Lalita Sahasranama. So that is, siddhas are basically powers that are there. So especially with Devi worship, goddess worship, we have a lot of such terms that are associated, wherein not just the plain chanting of the stotras, but we also need some Siddha Vidya. Siddha Vidya is maybe you chant the Lalita Sahasranama, you have some Bija mantras. I am Reem Shreem, just now you were seeing. Like this, why these mantras are.
Short hearing Bhagavat Seva?
Yes, Bhagavati Seva you have, right? Bhagavat Seva,
yeah.
We say it is actually Bhagavati Seva. There also
yeah,
we
yeah.
make this. So, especially you have this in the. Some reference you also get about these siddhas. So siddhas are basically you can say very powerful qualities, but siddhas are different methods that we use for performing shakti worship, and siddhas are those demigods or those gods who rule over all these different mudras and tantra practices that we do. They are considered to be the devotees of Lord Shiva and Parvati both together. Bhutas, very famous, Bhutaganas. Now this has got nothing to do. Though we say bhuta, bhuta, bhuta is again a very, like you asked for pishacha. Pishacha, bhuta, we have made a hype around it, saying that they are always going to be fearful. But basically bhuta ganas, mainly Lord Shiva, if you look at the bhuta ganas, for example, Nandikeshwara, or they look very absurd, right? They'll have big nose, big eyes, big ears, body of a human being. So like this, you can say mix and match. So not very pleasant to look, having the form of a human being. But somewhat you can consider them to be ghosts or spirits. But they are the devotees of Lord Vishnu. Lord Shiva again. They are these bhutas. Okay. Now, we have seen
one question, ma'am.
Yes.
This Gandharvas and Kinnaras, both of them are associated with music?
No, Gandharvas are associated with both music and dance. That is, they actually sing songs and they dance. Kinnaras, mainly they play musical instruments. That is
okay,
it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Okay, now we'll stop looking at the meanings. Let us continue learning. So, Brahma, 1.1.35. Nabhijanmandajav purvo nidhanav kamalodbhavah. Nabhijanmandajav purvo nidhanav kamalodbhavah. I don't know why today the network is troubling. Okay. Nadanadan chulle. Nabhijanmandajav purvo.
Nabhijanmandajav purvo.
Mandajav purvo.
Mandajav purvo.
Nidhanav kamalodbhavah.
Nidhanav kamalodbhavah.
Sada. Sureshji, Nabhijanmandajav purvo.
Nabhijanmandajav purvo.
Nidhanav kamalodbhavah.
Nidhanav kamalodbhavah.
Nabhijanmandajav purvo. Nidhanav kamalodbhavah. Sadanando rajo murtihi. Why Brahma is called Rajomurtihi, having the quality of Rajas, not exactly Sattva. Why it is so? When we look at the meanings, I will tell you. Sadanando Rajomurtihi, Satyako Hamsavahanaha, सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति सत्यको हंसवाहन श्यामला जी सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति
सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति
सत्यको हंसवाहन
सत्यको हंसवाहन
इंदिरा जी सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति
सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति
सत्यको हंसवाहन
सत्यको हंसवाहन
सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति सत्यको हंसवाहन नाभिजन्मांडज पूर्वो निधनः कमलोद्भवः सदानंदो रजो मूर्ति सत्यको हंसवाहनः नेक्स्ट सो विद दिस द नेम्स ऑफ ब्रह्मा एंड्स नेक्स्ट इज नेम्स ऑफ विष्णु विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्णो व्हेन वी ब्रेक एंड चैंट इट हैज टू बी कृष्णः ब्रेक सेव सर्गा विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्ण वैकुंठो विष्टरश्रवा विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्ण वैकुंठो विष्टरश्रवा शांभवी विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्ण
विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्ण
वैकुंठो विष्टरश्रवा श्रीकरि विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्ण वैकुंठो विष्टरश्रवा विष्णुर्नारायण कृष्ण वैकुंठो विष्टरश्रवा दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः केशवो माधवस्वभूः दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः केशवो माधवस्वभूः श्रीराम दामोदरो
दामोदरो
ऋषिकेशः
ऋषिकेशः
केशवो
केशवो
माधवस्वभूः श्री विद्याजी दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः
दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः
केशवो माधवस्वभूः
केशवो माधवस्वभूः
दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः केशवो माधवस्वभूः दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षो पुण्डरीकाक्षः व्हेन वी ब्रेक एंड चैंट दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः गोविंदो गरुडध्वजः दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः गोविंदो गरुडध्वजः रूपंका जी दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः
दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः
गोविंदो गरुडध्वजः
गोविंदो गरुडध्वजः
अलमेनुजी दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः
दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः
गोविंदो गरुडध्वजः दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः गोविंदो गरुडध्वजः पीताम्बरोच्युतशार्ङ्गी विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः पीताम्बरोच्युतशार्ङ्गी विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः एकता गर्ग जी एकता जी नो रविशंकर जी पीताम्बरोच्युतशार्ङ्गी
पीताम्बरो चुदशाकी
विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः
विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः
सर्वेश आर यू देयर
नमस्कार
सर चलो एकता जी बी रेडी नेक्स्ट आर कॉल यू पीताम्बरो चुदशांगी
पीताम्बरो चुदशांगी
विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः यस पीताम्बरः अच्युतः पीताम्बरो चुदशार्गी विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः
पीताम्बरो चुदशार्गी विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः
ओके थैंक यू उपेन्द्र इंद्र वरजः वरजः ब्रेक से विसर्ग चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः उपेन्द्र इंद्र वरजः चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः इंद्रावरजः उपेन्द्र इंद्र इंद्रावरजः हाँ लेट इट बी इंद्र सॉरी उपेन्द्र इंद्रावरजः करेक्ट इंद्र हाँ इंद्रावरः इंद्र अनदर नेम फॉर गॉडेस महालक्ष्मी वरः हस्बैंड करेक्ट इंद्रावरः सॉरी हाँ एकता जी अनम्यूट टेल उपेन्द्र इंद्रावरजः
उपेन्द्र इंद्रावरजः
चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः
चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः
हाँ योर डॉटर्स आर देयर राइट ऐश्वर्या जी चल उपेन्द्र इंद्र वरजः
उपेन्द्र इंद्र वरजः
चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः
चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः
उपेन्द्र इंद्र वरजः चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः रिपुः ब्रेक से विसर्ग वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः एवरीवन हाईलाइट अंडरलाइन वासुदेवः मेनी पीपल स्टिल मेक अ मिस्टेक दे डोंट नो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वसुदेवा वासुदेवा बोथ वसुदेवा वासुदेवा बोथ आर सेम नो वसुदेवास कृष्णास फादर वासुदेवास कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ वसुदेवस्य पुत्रः वासुदेवः हौ वी हैव दशरथस्य पुत्रः दाशरथिः सिमिलरली वसुदेवस्य पुत्रः वासुदेवः वाई एम टेलिंग दिस इज कॉमनली पीपल इंटरचेंज एंड यूज फॉर कृष्णा आल्सो दे विल कॉल वसुदेव नो इट इज वासुदेव सो मेक अ नोट हियर पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः यस राजेंद्र कुमार जी पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः
पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः
वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः
वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः
भुवनेश्वरी जी पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः
पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः
वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः
वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः
पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः I'll just chant the first six lines. विष्णुर्नारायणः कृष्णः वैकुण्ठो विष्टरश्रवाः दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः दामोदरो ऋषिकेशः केशवो माधवस्वभूः दैत्यारिः पुण्डरीकाक्षः गोविन्दो गरुडध्वजः पीताम्बरोऽच्युतशार्ङ्गी विश्वक्सेनो जनार्दनः उपेन्द्र इन्द्रावरजः चक्रपाणिश्चतुर्भुजः पद्मनाभो मधुरिपुः वासुदेवस्त्रिविक्रमः Does someone know what is Indra Vajra, Upendra Vajra? Have you heard the name?
Chandas.
That is the reason here when we chant. In fact, you would have noted me also when I chanted Upendra Indra Vajra, right? if you are used to the chandas, you'll make this mistake. What is chandas? Anushtup chandaha, very popular. Like this, we have a chandas, a meter. Upendra Vajra, Indra Vajra. That is different. Here it is Upendra Indra Varajaha. Don't get confused like I did. Okay. Devaki Nandana Shaurihi Shripatif Purushottamaha. Devaki Nandana Shaurihi Shripatif Purushottamaha. Sundareshji. Devaki Nandana Shaurihi.
Devaki Nandana Shaurihi
Shripatif Purushottamaha.
Shripatif Purushottamaha.
Ranjaniji. Devaki Nandana Shaurihi.
Devaki Nandana.
Ranjaniji chan, unmute.
Devaki Nandana Shaurihi
Shripatif Purushottamaha.
Shripatif Purushottamaha.
Devaki Nandana Shaurihi Shripatif Purushottamaha. Vanamali Balidvamsi. Note here, Vanamali li is dirga and bali is small. Vanamali Balidvamsi Kamsara Tiradhokshajaha. Be careful here. Kamsa Ratira Drokshajaha. Vanamali Balidvamsi Kamsara Tiradhokshajaha. Jituji. Vanamali Balidvamsi.
Vanamali Balidvamsi
Kamsara Tiradhokshajaha.
Sara Tiradhokshajaha.
Shiva Sundarji. Vanamali Balidvamsi.
Vanamali Balidvamsi
Kamsara Tiradhokshajaha.
Kamsara Tiradhokshajaha.
Vanamali Balidvamsi Kamsara Tiradhokshajaha. Vishwambharav Kaitabhajid. Kaitabhajid, you can say. Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha. Vishwambharav Kaitabhajid. Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha. Anuradha V. Vishwambharav.
Vishwambharav
Kaitabhajid.
Kaitabhajid.
Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha.
Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha.
Rama Swaminathanji. Vishwambharav.
Vishwambharav
Kaitabhajid.
Kaitabhajid.
Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha.
Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha.
Vishwambharav Kaitabhajid. Vidushri Vatsalanchanaha. Purana Purusho Yajna Purusho Narakantakaha. Purana Purusho Yajna Purusho Narakantakaha. Sushil ji chant. Purana Purusho Yajna. Sushil ji unmute. No. Kamakshi ji. No. Chant. Purana Purusho Yajna.
Purana Purusho Yajna Purusho.
Purusho Narakantakaha.
Purusho Narakantakaha.
Ramyaji. Purana Purusho Yajna.
Purana Purusho Yajna.
Purusho Narakantakaha.
Purusho Narakantakaha.
Now everyone note, when we chant together, Purana Purusho Yajna Purusho. Yajna Purusho is one word. Because now we are breaking and chanting, we are taking a pause. Otherwise when you chant together, it is one word. Purana Purusho Yajna Purusho Narakantakaha. Jalashayi Vishwarupo. Vishwarupaha. When we break and chant. Jalashayi Vishwarupaha. Mukundo Muramardanaha. Jalashayi Vishwarupaha. मुकुंदो मुरमर्दनः कमलाजी जलशायी विश्वरूपः मुकुंदो मुरमर्दनः चंद्रिका जी जलशायी विश्वरूपः मुकुंदो मुरमर्दनः जलशायी विश्वरूपः मुकुंदो मुरमर्दनः ओके आई जस्ट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 43 देवकी नंदनशौरिः श्रीपतिः पुरुषोत्तमः वनमाली बलिध्वंसी कंसारातिरधोक्षजः विश्वंबरः कैटभजिद् विदुश्री वत्सलाञ्छनः पुराणपुरुषो यज्ञ पुरुषो नरकान्तकः जलशायी विश्वरूपः मुकुंदो मुरमर्दनः विद दिस नेम्स ऑफ विष्णु एंड नेक्स्ट वन लाइन वसुदेव कृष्णास फादर वसुदेवो हियर यू हैव वसुदेव इन कृष्णा फॉर विष्णु इट इज वासुदेव वसुदेवोस्य जनकः स एवानकदुन्दुभिः वसुदेवः यस्य जनकः वसुदेवोस्य जनकः स एवानकदुन्दुभिः स एव आनकदुन्दुभिः आनकदुन्दुभिः लिटरली मीन्स बिग ड्रम्स इट सीम्स दैट व्हेन Vasudeva was born, Shri Krishna's father, lot of big drums were being played. That's how the boy got the name Anakadundubihi. This reference you get in Srimad Bhagavatam also, where for Vasudeva this word is used, Anakadundubihi. Vasudevo sya janakah sa eva anakadundubihi. Sanjeev ji. Vasudevo sya janakah.
Vasudevasya janakah.
स एवानकदुन्दुभिः मीना आर् जलश सॉरी वसुदेवोऽस्य जनकः स एवानकदुन्दुभिः वसुदेवोऽस्य जनकः स एवानकदुन्दुभिः Okay, today time is up. We will stop here.